Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the next video about community communications and the consensus seeking process. As you've seen the other videos with the new governance model, we have the possibility to write down how the workflow should look like so that users know what they can expect. And at the moment I did set everything to 100% consensus, so as long as there is discussion going on, merge request cannot be merged, which is a little bit strict. Still, it may work. So if all the developers, if they reach consensus, then something can be merged. But it should be a little bit easier and a little bit more structured. And for this, we have a closer look at about GitLab tiddlywiki.org project, which is a group and a namespace. I changed the user, which I'm here PMario now, which has full access to everything. Yeah. So the overall structure is like this. There is a tiddlywiki.org group, where different members can join. Basically everyone which wants to be part of the tiddlywiki.org can join, let's say, this level. And then there are different roles. Yeah. So we have a guest role, a reporter, developers, master and owner. And if you are there, then you can see, let's say, the whole structure and create issues or merge requests or whatever, depending on the level of rights that you have. And then we have different subgroups. So for example, one is documentation. So this is the tiddlywiki home and documentation. So it should contain the German documentation, not the translation. It's something different. So there is some, or I did translate content from tiddlywiki.com and made a German version. Then there is a French version. Then this should be the source for the static homepage. So the source home directory contains this info with the templates and everything. And there is the English documentation, which is, let's say, tiddlywiki.com. It's the extended documentation, because Jeremy wants the core documentation, so the reference documentation, inside the core. The goal here is that we find users that are, or that want to contribute to the documentation. And some of those users even may have write access to the different repositories, because this German is a repository. So this then contains the real code. So the docs is the group. Everyone which is part of the documentation group maybe is interested in also in different languages, because I would contribute to German and English. I cannot contribute to French, but there may be some Switzerland guys. They may be able to contribute to German, to the French version, to the Italian version, and to the English version. So that's why it's called group documentation. Then there is another group which is called editions, which contains the different templates, which is at the moment the different editions from tiddlywiki. And I definitely think that those editions need a different life cycle than the core. So that's why there is a different group which can update the editions in a much faster pace than the core. Then there are the plugins. There are the standard plugins, which the community can maintain. And there should be also possibilities. For example, I want to have a new project where I say, okay, I want to have a public project and I want to have my Wikilabs. Wikilabs plugins that they are part of the community. Toby Bear may have his own plugins, and someone else may want to have these plugins. And the cool thing here is, with this structure, it's possible. Yeah, because we can say, okay, if you are part of the plugins group, yeah, and we trust you enough that you can merge something into master, yeah, and you have to have two or three upvotes from key developers, otherwise you cannot merge to master, then this structure is possible. Plugins. Then we have all the translations. Not all the translations, this is translators edition. There is an edition with TiddlyWiki which you can download, and it should be possible to transfer the information to the per mail or something like this. And I wanted to have one group which improves this translators edition. So then there are the different themes, and themes is the same thing as with plugins. There should be the possibilities that the themes group adds new projects to the tiddlywiki.org, to the organization. The different repositories are still completely independent. All the copyrights and so on, they all belong to the different authors if they want. Then there is the base element, which is the core, the TiddlyWiki core, which contains almost everything. So the whole code plus the languages. Needs a little bit longer. I didn't push it yet. Okay, so no problem. TiddlyWiki core. Then there is the organizational structure, which I call Senatus. You can have a look at Wikipedia, what it means. And it contains the committee, and since everything should be open, all the projects, everything is public, so that all the discussions, all the issues can be seen by the whole community. Then there is a repository which is called dist for distribution, not used at the moment, just for playing. Then there is the feature request section, which you know already. Feature requests handles the feature request issues and the board. So different possibilities. And now I have the possibility to say, okay, I switch it over to under consideration or to plugin territory. I say, okay, it's part of the backlog. If you have seen the other videos, I couldn't switch it, but now I have all the rights, I can switch it. Okay, feature request. And then there are some test elements. This is the repository which hosts the main page here. And as you can see, there is no HTTPS connection because I made a mistake. tiddlywiki.org.gitlab.io doesn't work at the moment. But there is a problem with the certificates. So that's why we may need to switch to tiddlywiki-org or /org, something like this, not /org. German landing page only for testing, and the videos is this one. So this GitLab talk TiddlyWiki is posted here. At the moment this is also used for testing the CI/CD process, because if we have this file which is active, then the CI/CD does all the publishing, everything is done automatically. So if I push changes, the homepage is updated automatically. So this is for testing mainly. What we need to establish now, so this is, let's say, the basic structure. What we need to establish now is how can someone become a member, which will be part of the next video. And see you soon.